Good afternoon. How are you? I'm not fine. So today we will talk about Latin hormonal health. But I think you probably have heard before. Anyone heard about Latin hormonal? No? You know we have heard before. We will talk about how to make. Yeah, thank you very much. How you will learn about how to look after your teeth or something else that you will do after. And the first thing you need to do is know your teeth first. You have to know your teeth. The first thing you have to know what it's called for this. When you learn about teeth, the truth will understand what it's different. You understand?
Yes.
Yeah? Okay, you understand. So, anyone like to have your teeth like this? Of course, yeah. Yeah. Everybody like to have a teeth like this. Or even like this. Okay? But we won't be like this. Why we think we don't like that? But we see a lot of students or teenagers have the teeth like this right now. If you even in your class, in your room, or you out for a public area, like on the road or on the bus, you can see a lot of people in the news. And we won't, in our public health and career, we won't like to see the people have all the screen around their teeth. You know why? You know why they have to do it? Because they have more big function of their teeth. Their teeth cannot come to the right. So they have to fix it to make it right. That's what they have the problem. When they have problem, they have to fix it out like that. Okay? So first thing before we starting about public health, you have to know what the teeth call for each one. We have to look at the mouth and separate them for 4 seconds. After you separate in 4 seconds, you might change them for the name for each section. One section, you will be for that, for that. You have to look for it for each section. Section on the up, right? No, upright. Look at when you look at the mirror. When you look at the mirror, when you look at yourself, yeah, on the right hand, and on the upper arm, when you look at your mouth, you can see upper arm, lower, upper, lower. Then we separate them in the middle, on the right hand side and left hand side. So for each part, we call up, right, then up, left, then bottom right, and bottom left. So we come for 4 sections. For 4 sections, we put the name on. For the name, we have 8 numbers. We have 8 numbers. We use 4 numbers for the quadrant that belong to permanent teeth. Do you know permanent teeth? When we talk about the teeth, we have 2 types of the teeth. The first one we call hybrid teeth. Hybrid is really mobility. They have set up before. They have come before. Or if you are dentist or dental young people, we don't call hybrid teeth, we call disc teeth. So for the permanent teeth, we do number 1, 2, 3, 4 for each quadrant. So we can see the quadrant 1 is for the up right. Okay? And quadrant 2 is for the up left. Then quadrant 3 is down, what do you call?
Bottom
left. And then the The last one. That is for number, for the permanent case. And then we use the other four, yes? Number four to number eight. Number four to number eight. It belongs to this vertex or permanent case. It's happened before, but the number we use for the last. Yeah, we don't use 1 to 4 for the primary, but we use 1 to 4 for permanent. And it for this one, for family, the same name. So we use pattern 5 for up, right? And then up, left for number 6. Bottom left for number 7, and bottom right and number 8. That is third number when we call the name of the teeth. Then when we go to, I'm sorry, then we go for the second number. The number of the teeth, when you look at your teeth, when we call number 1 to number 8 for all total. When number 1 is start from the middle line, when you look at the middle line, you know when you learn about anatomy, when you separate your body for two parts, for right and left, the middle that we separate will become middle line. So the teeth that closes to number to middle line we call is number 1. So for each for them, you can see they have four number of number 1. Yeah? This is middle line. And then you count from 1 and then count until the end of the mouth. It will be inside the mouth, the limbic of inside, until number 8. So totally, when we count for permanent teeth, how many we have?
Flow up for each for them. So totally we have how many?
you can call milky teeth. And you can have milky teeth like that. Okay? It don't belong to this diet. So you can see we start from number one, from the middle. From the middle. And then upper from upper arm and lower arm. Okay? So the back pain when we draw up for the teeth, normally we got like this, or like a new chair. But if we draw up, we draw it up like this, we can see the teeth in one column, or all are moving like this. You can see that's the anatomy for them. So when you look this in a real tooth, it's a real tooth, but here, is middle of your middle line. You can see the number one, number two, number three, and number four, number five, number six. Even this finger, you can see number eight down there. It can't grow up, and we not cut it. If we have like this, that's made the impact teeth. But the emphasis for this is just not at all. Planning to affect. You know about attention? The attention tool is mean pull out from your jaw. You pull out and then call attraction. Attract is not kinesis, it's just S. Okay, so for the number, we have their name. You can call the number or you can call their name. Like number one, the closet one will be the line. How many? Number one, how many? In my mouth, because it's in the middle, so we call central incisor. Central incisor is mean it's in the center of the mouth, so we call central. So central is mean center, it's center. And incisor to mean in the chaha. When they call something incisor, they go inside the chaha, they can cut. So the next one from central, we call it tooth. The next to central, we call it tooth. It also falls inside because the volume all the same. We use for cutting. Okay? That's the number two. The by the your mouth, we have something along your mouth to make your mouth beautiful or even your face beautiful. They call cupid. Do you know what a cupid is? A little guy when you come to modern time. Can I or cupid teeth? It can control the shape of the jaw. If you got a can I come to the right place, your jaw might be the new shape and your mouth and your face will be beautiful. But if you don't collapse down or come up, make your mouth not to the new chair. And to make the teeth look abnormal. So we can think about it, canine very important to make a people body of the face in a chair and beautiful. So the number four. The number four we use for chew the food. So we call like the mold, you know about the mold? When you use to kill something, you will feel killing. Yeah? We use before molar. So number four, it will be the first one, so we call third molar. And then number five, it's called second molar. In the number of the primary teeth, or milky teeth, or mandibular, we have only five. But how many in a permanent? How many? How many teeth in a permanent? Eight. Do you see the different name from number one, number five for milky? Which one is different? Yes. We have premolar. The other, they are the same. We have incisors, still the same. canine, number three, all the same, like primary teeth. But we got number four and number five all different. We call P molar. P is when they come first, they come before molar. So when you look at your teeth, the P molar come before molar. P molar don't have in your teeth for permanent. It's only for permanent teeth. So another one come up is in the milky teeth or this gap, you don't have number 8. Only third and second. For the primary, you have third molar. Okay? So three tools come in permanent teeth and the name change different. Right. That's what we call. If you look at the picture, you can see like that. At number 8, we call different charms. Like in Thailand, we can hear about fun food, but also for wisdom, too. We call it for wisdom because they don't know more, like the other. The shape is changing. It can be like premolar, or it can be like molar. Or it can be go the same time, grow up the same time, like second premolar, or number 7. Or if someone comes to the right time when you are 18, it should be calm. But some body probably don't come at all. It might be under your gum, or impact under your bone. In your jaw. That's what why we call a whisper. If we don't know about it. But then we can look only expert they will be. Okay? That's what when we look at the how you call your teeth. You can call the number for two numbers or you can call by their function. This is what they do. Can I, what can I do? Can I do? Normally, what do you use your can I for? Tearing food. Tearing food. No. If you, this is cut. Cutting food. Incisor, we use for cutting food. But canine, we use for tearing. Tearing food. And then molar, we use for grinding. Do that. The grinding. Then we grinding like the molar. And we have to keep molar. We have to do two functions. Because people are close to canine and close to molar, so they shape on occipital plane. On the top we call occipital plane. It can do for both. You do for tearing and biting. They can do like molar or canine. That is premolar. But they change very similar from canine and molar. This is what they function with this. Okay? Right. When you call the number, can I have to remind you? This is their position. Incisor is always in the body. Yeah? Position of in the mouth. Incisor in the front, and then canine is to be incisor and canine. If the primary teeth, where they are about canine, they will be between. In primary teeth. Number 5, which side of the